My wife received an email saying probably February timeframe.
Some people in Cape Coral won't have their internet for months. That is what representatives from both Xfinity and CenturyLink told city leaders tonight during a special meeting. Thanks for counting on NBC2. I'm Peter Bush.
And I'm Kyla Gaylor. Thousands of you living in Cape Coral don't have the service you need to work and stay connected. Tonight, NBC2's Gage Golding is live in the Cape. So, Gage, which customers will have to wait the longest for internet?
Right now, it looks to be CenturyLink customers. An executive with the company said today that a small group of computers or customers' computers might look like this, no internet, and it might look like this through the first couple months of 2023. And both companies, CenturyLink and Xfinity, had major damage to their network, especially along the coastline. And here's a great example. 3 weeks after Ian made landfall, there are still cables running across the streets here in the Cape. Do you have internet?
We do not have internet.
For thousands across Cape Coral, they're in the same boat.
I haven't seen any CenturyLink trucks, whether they're not labeled or not, but I haven't seen any CenturyLink trucks, only Xfinity trucks driving around town.
But both companies told city leaders they're here and working around the clock.
We have over 1,700 crew in the area. We've called in from 12 other states.
We registered about 22,000 residents impacted by the storm.
Right now, CenturyLink appears to be the worst off. About 6,600 customers in the city are without services. That's down from 22,000 right after Ian hit.
The level of damage is significant, and so I do anticipate that last customer likely to come up somewhere in that first quarter.
That means some won't have internet or TV until the first few months of next year, something Mayor John Gunter wanted to make sure he heard right.
So what you're saying is the CenturyLink customers could be without their internet or their service up to the first quarter of next year.
That's correct.
Like many others, Robert can't wait. They not only want internet, but they need it.
My daughter, for instance, relies on it to do her job. We're switching providers in the meantime. I signed up for T-Mobile. They have a home hotspot.
Xfinity says they're 95% restored in Cape Coral. Jen Boyette with Xfinity didn't have the actual number of customers without service or an answer to when everyone could be reconnected.
When do you anticipate getting to 100%? Do you have a goal in mind or a set date?
We do not. The only thing that we can ask them to do is sit tight and be patient.
All right, sit tight and be patient. If you're seeing the little jumping dinosaur guy on your no internet screen, Xfinity has previously said they expect all customers will have service by the end of the year. They say they know exactly which customers don't have service, so you don't need to call them. They're just asking you, like you heard there, to sit tight. Now, as for CenturyLink, they want you to call them because they don't know. Maybe it's a problem with your phone or computer inside your house, or maybe even the equipment, or maybe it's something outside, like a cable running across the street. They want to know everything specific to your situation. But look, if you don't have internet, it really doesn't matter what company you have right now. It could be a while, maybe even a couple months, before you are plugged back in. I'm reporting live in Cape Coral tonight. Gage Golding, NBC2.